Pum, pum, pum. Ja, moin. Muss noch hier meinen Chat einrichten. So, das könnt ihr nicht sehen. Das ist auf meinem zweiten Bildschirm. You can't see it. It's on my secondary screen. So, this is our routing today from Nouakchott to Gao. And in Gao, we make a quick stop. And then we continue here to the Algerian desert. That's Bouch Mokhtar. So it's about 2 hours 15 here, and then maybe 50 minutes for the second flight. All right. No, we're not flying with the Cessna. Don't worry. I need to load. Yeah, that's correct. Real world time, start new flight, start new flight. Active sky. The meantime, we can rename the chart files Gagu and move them into the right directory. All right, so something is not right here. I have updated. Nothing works. Uh-oh. What's going on here? Nothing works. I just updated the Zeebo to version 2.22 and nothing works. Oh shit. Okay, why is this? So something. No, I'm not. I'm a real pilot, but not 737, no. All right, so something is messed up here, and we don't know why. Okay, I have to shut down, explain, and try again. If it doesn't help, I have to go back to version 21. Or I could reinstall version 22 and see if it makes a difference. So, X-plane, aircraft. X, there we go. Well, let's see if we're lucky. I fly a private jet. Which is a bit more challenging than flying airline. Well, it's different. I wouldn't say it's always harder, but it's different. And has its own challenges. In the airlines, I would fall asleep. Too boring. So, resume last flight. Well, let's make a new flight to confirm numbers. Yeah, it's the Boeing, it's Newark shot. Yeah, let's try it again. Yep, I fly a Falcon, but not a 7X. I fly a Falcon 2000 EX, easy, at least so far. Maybe I just got fired, I don't know. With all the bloody virus panic. So, how are we doing now? Yay! We're back in business. I don't know what happened before. Must have been some hiccup. What do we have to do? Start flight lag, connect the GPU, IRS to nav. Yaw damper. Let me quickly start Swift. Here you can see Swift, the online client, pilot client for VATSIM here on the second flight plan. Let's load it from SimBrief. Okay, there we go. That's all cool. Flight plan, let's make it direct go and equipment code Lima. Then we connect to VATSIM and we are IKEA, fly IKEA 234. Send flight plan. Let's do it again just to be sure. Flight plan sent. On the radar, there's nobody around, that's good. ATC, there's nobody around in the area, that's good. Unicom, let's go here to the payload and fuel. So first we have to refuel. How much fuel do we need? How much is the fish? No, come here. Where is it? Here. How much is the fish? So we need 12.2 tons of fuel. Oh, that will take a while. Which means we have a lot of time to set up the FMS. So fuel truck. Okay, filling up. Payload. 11.5 tons. FMS. First we do the ACARS here. We are in Gulf, Quebec. November Oscar. Send. So 310 knots, runway 34 in Houston, 5 kilometers, blowing dust, 25 1011. Oh. Somehow this is coupled now. This is not good. Not here. General config off. And now? Okay, now it stopped moving, but as well it stopped adjusting the FO side. It's not good. Well, I'll have to live with it. Okay then, let's go menu, FMC, init, G, Q, and O. Copy, paste. There we go to, we're flying nach Gago. 01. Activate. Ah, so alternate fuel, 2.3 tons and 1.1, that's 3.4. Everything else is extra fuel, cost index 50. Ah, I didn't change the cost index. Now we're gonna cruise a bit slower, but doesn't matter. We change it. Let's make it 80. 797, a bit more. 89, that's too much. 86, it's too much. Okay, 85 then, and that's it. Take off flaps 5. But the gross weight is not final yet, we're still refueling. Runway 34 for takeoff, there's no SID. So we just go to Kitas. How are we doing with the fuel? Okay, half of what we need. So auto brake, RTO, let's do the overhead panel, we can start the APU. Continue here, window heat, hydraulic electric pumps, packs, auto, isolation valve override, APU bleed on, cruising level 370. What's the elevation of our destination? Heavy tap charts, cargo elevation 870, so we need 900 feet. No. 900. Fire nav light on. We're still refueling, so we must not switch on the fastened belts. That has to stay off until refueling is finished, and only then can we select seat belts on and close the doors. So this is the chart for our destination. So we will only need it later on. Okay, let's have a look. Yep, APU generator available, connected. So we can disconnect the APU. And we go back to our... Oh, can... Welcome, level of prepare. No, there's nothing.
Two, three, four. United, one. United, two. Southwest, one. Southwest, two. American Airlines, American Airlines, Delta One, Ryanair, 2E Fly, German. One, two, three, four, United.
Okay.
Four.
Let's see. So fuel. Well, we still have 3 tons to go. Let's have a look at our aircraft. The situation put us a little bit too far to the front. So, well, what can we do? Let's call the pushback.
Ground cockpit. Tow is driving up.
Okay, let me quickly fetch some water. I'll be back shortly.
Okay, all doors and hatches are closed, ready to connect.
Hello again, so we're getting there. Cool. Fueling is finished, so we can as well go ahead with the FMS. So 66.8 for the fuel. Let's see. Takeoff 66.6 sounds good. Zero fuel 54.5. Yep, it's within limits. It's okay. And then we can, yeah, insert the speeds. Oh, just the CG 19.8 for our pitch trim for takeoff. There we go, trim 6.0. There we go. Oops. So V2 147 knots. So we set 147 here for takeoff. And we do flight director on, heading and VNAV. Because there's no SID, there's nothing to follow with LNAV initially. Cool. So we're gonna push back, facing to the south, southeast, and then taxi right and left all the way down to holding point runway 34. There's an ILS 10.9. We take off and we go our way. We make a right turn. We make a right turn out, we go to Ketas, but probably we're gonna just shortcut and go direct to Sepel to save a few miles. And yeah, that's it basically. Engine failure, straight out. We climb to MSA, which is about 2,000 feet, and make a left turn, and we come back for the ILS approach runway 34. And ASL, or target altitude set 37,000 feet, or rather level 370. And we are good here. There's a VOR Oscar Tango. Huh? I think it's called Fix Oscar Tango. Yeah, 2 miles from here. The frequency I do not know from memory, so I have to look it up here on this map. It's not shown in this map, maybe in this one? No. No. Wow. Okay, 15.6, okay. I don't know why the chart is not showing the VUR symbol. That's weird. Fifteen six, but we have it active and we have the DME and the needle to it. So let's go. Ground services, pushback.
Ground to cockpit. Please show me where you want to go.
I make a short pushback here.
Tow connected and bypass pin inserted. Release parking brake.
Released. Beacon on.
Starting pushback. And you may
on.
Start engines.
Boarding is now complete. Flight attendants, prepare the cabins. Verify arm door standby for all call.
Before start, do list, fuel pumps on. Lights out. Packs off. It's all good. And let's start engine number 2. Let's have it here. It's a bit more compact. And fuel on. EGT rising. N1 rising. And starting engine number one. Start valve open, N2 rising, waiting for N2 about 23-24% before we select the fuel from cutoff to idle. Now idle, fuel flow, EGT rising, and N1 rising. Looking good.
Operation complete. Set parking brake.
Park brake set.
Disconnecting tow. Completed. Stand by.
Let's do the after start do list. Generators connect. APU off. Probe heat on. All pumps on. Ignition continuous. Pack auto auto. Valve auto. APU valve closed. Flaps to 5. Flaps moving. In the meantime, trim 6 checked. Flaps 5, green light.
Tow is disconnected, bypass bin has been removed. Hand signal on the left. We'll see you next time and have a safe flight.
Thank you very much. Thumbs up, taxi light on, brake released, let's go. So first right, first left, and then all the way to the holding point of runway 34. Oh. Bloody switches in my throttle quadrant, they sometimes they get confused here. Now it's fine. So wing light on to make the cabin ready for departure.
Okay, the cabin is secured. Have a good flight.
Transponder Tara. Auto throttle is armed. So we got flaps, trim, target altitude, heading select green, VNAV is armed, P2 147 knots, safe altitude 2000 feet, left hand turn over the sea, come back for ILS 34. And the runway is long and dry, so we can afford to abort up to V1 without any problem.
Approaching 3-4. On runway 3-4.
Here we are. Center the heading buck. Off we go. Elapsed time running. Toga. Thrust set. Oh, we lost the heading select. Why is that?
80 knots.
Checked. The heading select mode, why is that? Heading select green.
400.
VNAV speed green. Direct KTAS, LNAV green. No, I don't want to make 1000. A left turn, I want to make a right turn. So we turn right against the flight director. Now we'll reinsert the direct to again in a moment. Okay, now the flight director is coming back. Hey Claudio, grüezi wohl. Wir machen jetzt gemütlichen Flug, wir machen comfortable flight, relaxed flight, 2 hours flying time, so I can wash my windows from all the bloody Polish people, pollen, from spring. Speed check, flaps up selected. Target speed 250. Yep, standard set. So I will roll out here and I will insert direct to this point KTAS one more time. We don't want to fly these S curves. There we go. Enough green. So So at the moment I'm aiming at pitch 10 degrees to accelerate back to 250. And now I'm slowly raising the nose again, following the flight director. But it needs quite a bit of trimming here. Here's the airport. Here's the airport. Just took off from Nouakchott. Mauritania, desert. Der Nachtisch. Right, then autopilot command, green, LNAV, VNAV, green. We can do the other takeoff checks. Landing gear is up and off, auto brake off, ignition auto, taxi light off. Flaps are up and light out. Anything else? Probably I should have a look at the checklist. So engine bleeds on, PAX auto, landing gear up, off, flaps up, no lights, descent checklist next. So we covered it all. Well, let's go direct to the next point, CPL. There's a shortcut here. There we go. Bye bye Atlantic Ocean, see you later. We passed level 100. Landing lights off, wing light off, fasten belts off. Center tank still 3.6 tons, so that's a while until we have to think about these center fuel pumps. So, that's our routing in Cute Scoop. There we go. We can switch off this here, route display. And here is our routing. It's okay. It's not as well visible as before, but that's the way it is. I could have flown here in Mumbai, Mumbai to Male. I would have done too late now. Yeah, it's a pity that these controllers do not add any information what airspace they are covering. Yeah, Mumbai, Mumbai. Yeah, is it including the Maldives or not? Yeah, Asia as well is quite active. Here that's Manila. We have Jakarta. Singapore is online. We have Vietnam. Hanoi control. Oh, as well, for this I have to change the code for this airspace here. I will do it in a moment. And as well we have here RKDA. As well, that's new center. Deco control, okay. Interior control. So he says he's controlling what airport? Romeo Kilo Tango Uniform, let's have a look. Romeo Kilo Tango Uniform. Where are you? Tango Alpha. Tango Sierra. Tango Hotel. I am here. Tango November. This area here. Looks like they have changed as well their sectorization. Let's have a look. Edit patch. We need fear display? No, the other one. FIR list. So, let's see, Hanoi. No. Let's try this. I copy the line and I just rename this to VVVV. And then RK Daegu. Incheon. Ah, Daegu and Daegu. Let me try. Ah, it's all the same sector, so we could just add this one. What's the name? So this is Rima Romeo Kilo Romeo Romeo, yeah, and this is Romeo Kilo Delta Alpha. Romeo Kilo Delta Alpha. Let's have a look. Reload the program and see if the sectorization looks okay or not. Yep. That looks fine. You can even have a look here. Now there is probably there should be a split between these two airspaces here, between Incheon control and Daegu control, but it's not in the data, so you have to wait for somebody to make a general update. Is it the same here for Vietnam? Yeah, it is. Oh well. Europe is active. Well, now more or less. Oh, people I know have time. Flying to Denver, arriving in tonight at 10:47 p.m. our time here in Europe. Maybe I'll join him for landing. Let me ask him if he's going to be there as well. Do I know him? Oh, that's I know what you're saying. So this says we still have to go 1 hour and 57. ETA 1529Z. Does this match what we have in our FMC? 1527 plus approach, yeah, that's quite accurate. So let's hunt for more airspace that is not recognized at the moment. Well, ATC stations at the moment, there's nothing. Wow, there's a big group here, South Africans. They're probably flying non-stop from Cape Town or from... Oh, they're flying from Mauritius to Perth. I see. What? Perth, yeah, here. Weather in Perth, Kavok, 18 degrees. Yeah, well, it's autumn there. Why not? As we can see, there's nobody around here, so we don't need to even look out for traffic. We still have to go a little bit until we reach our top of climb, another 10,000 feet. So we've corrected this, so we can close it. In the meantime, we can generate the flight plan from Gao to this other place in Algeria. Let's call it... what's the name? port. So call it Bravo Mokta. Bravo like port. So we go from DATM. No. From Gargo to DATM. And alternate, probably we take here, Tamanraset, DAAT, Delta Alpha, Alpha Tango. Yeah, it's hot here, 43 degrees here, look at this. This is hot, 42, 41, 42. No, I don't want to lift 42. 40 degrees in Kano. And then we wonder why people do crazy things, eh? The weather's crazy, people do crazy crazy things. Hiccup. So Delta Alpha Alpha Tango. And we're gonna take off at 1600 probably. Cost index 85. Scheduled on ride time 1 hour. That's okay. Extra fuel, we don't need much, we'll take 15 minutes. Actually we can aim at landing with, departing with our landing fuel. We're expecting to land with 6.8, so let's plan 6.5 tons takeoff fuel. And we see. And the routing. See. Uniform Golf 5859. But is it part of is backup? Probably backup. Unicorn Golf 859, I think it was. 859 to Mokhat. Yep, works. Can I select anywhere how much fuel I want to have at least? Oh, let's see. Generate flight plan. Yeah. Ah, 6.5. Hey, that was just pure luck. So 55 minutes flying time for the second leg. Oh, that's fine. Cool. Then we're done. Fuel planning was... can already tell sim brief. Download and export. That's it. Actually, I could have left. Oh, there's another airway. Golf Tango 10. No, So, significant weather is fine. There's a jet stream further up here at level 420 with 15 knots. Okay, go away. At least this remove the airways. It's too much clutter. Remove the VORs. Too much clutter. So here we can see the FIR borders. So just on this flight, so what's our position? We're approaching Nalet. That's here. So we're still in good range from Nouakchott in case we have to go return or so. There's the airfield, 41 degrees. Nioro du Sahel. Case. Don't know this airport. Here's an airport. Kiffer. Yeah, no comment. Kiffer. And the next year, Bamako will be a beam later on. Bamako, we could go to here. And then the next will be here, Mopti Ambo Dejo. So that's at Bamako. 13.7.
13.7.
And finally, we are reaching our top of climb after 20 minutes. Yeah, but it's hot. We are not that light. Enough path green, FMC speed 0.80, that's good. Nice ground speed, 520 knots almost, very nice. Alright guys, so I'll be in the background now for a few minutes. I want to wash some windows to remove all the pollen from lovely plants outside from springtime. I'm going to be back here in 5 or 10 minutes. So stay safe, behave. So, I'm back, bin ich zurück. Ja. Wir drehen eine Runde beim Kiffer, ja. So, what's the weather? Cargo. No meter data. Ooh, is that nice? Let's see what our weather briefing in active sky says. Flight plan load from GQ Kogo DATM. Okay, briefing, let's see. Go condition 060 degrees, 7 knots, good visibility, good clouds, 40 degrees, 1008, advanced interpolation. And because there's no meter, so easterly winds, 1008. Means we need runway 07, Arnath 7 left, Arima. Ooh, let's have a look at the charts. Charts, Gao, runway 07. So Arima, Tutul, and Dilba. Dilba. Off. Yeah. Dilba, 2500 feet. Continue for 5 miles and then final descent. Let's have a look. He's got the same here. Dilba, saying 2.5 or above. Let's make it at 2500 feet so we can actually stay fast and slow down and holding at. Oh no. Dilba. No, we don't want to hold at Dilba. No. Why is there a holding? Okay, it's here in the code, yeah. Indeed. Doesn't matter. We removed the holding. Can we delete it like this? No, we can't. So we will reinsert this manually and make it 240/2500 feet and then to the final approach fix. That works. Cool. So estimating 1533 Zulu. Landing VREF 140. Flaps 40. Wind correction 5 is fine. And it's only an LNAV minimum. Again, so we have LNAV for horizontal guidance, but we need to use vertical speed for vertical guidance. Or command, rather. Alright, guys. I will go with the dog for a walk now. I will be back here in minimum half hour, probably 45 minutes. So if you want to watch, be my guest. If not, I don't mind. If you drop out, just do something different. So the action will probably start from 15 Zulu on 15:10 Zulu on 10 past 5 local time in Europe. Right, see you later, guys. Bye bye. Hallo Leute, ich bin zurück. I'm back. Also, we are reaching our top of descent. Sorry for those who just joined, I was out with the dog. So I had a master caution here, fuel, because the center tank fuel is empty. So we switch off these pumps and we are close to our top of descent, maybe, you know, 15 miles. So let me set level 100 preliminary and see what the plane will do. We are planning for a RNF runway 07 left. It's LNAV only. Minimum is 1300 feet. With a runway elevation of 836. At the moment we're planning to cross Dilba at 2500 and we have a level segment of 5 miles. That's sufficient to slow down and configure the plane at Golf Oscar 501. It's our final approach fix, so we have 5 miles from starting our descent to the runway. The runway threshold is the missed approach point. It's a standard 3-degree descent path. We have some check altitudes on the way down. And our MSA is 2400 feet in all sectors. So we can set 2500 here. 2500. And we are on descent, so I set QNH 1008 active. Yeah, we're still in the Sahel. Very arid, dry, desert-like. Let's have a look for our FMC points here. So Dilba, Goa, 2500, then runway 07 left, and missed approach. Climb straight ahead at Golf Oscar 502, turn right, climbing 2500 to Arima, and we can start another approach there. And we got the same here, yeah. Cool, huh? Arima, 2500. Drag required? No, I think so. I don't think so. Let's check again our landing configuration. Oh, yeah. 3 knots less. Runway length is not spectacular. It's only 8,200 feet. Probably it's even less because there's a displaced threshold. Let's see. Oh, no, it's the same. It's fine. It's just a stopway here. So the runway counts from here to here. Runway course 065 degrees. And is there a VOR at the airfield? I think there is one. Yeah, here, GAU VOR 12.3. But no reception yet. If you wonder where we're flying to, we're going here to Gao. And Gao is not far from here, you see, Niamey, we've been there. Here's Ouagadougou, Niamey, so we've been in the area before. Yeah, 07 right, exactly. No. I'm quickly away, I need to get some water. Quite thirsty. Okay then, fasten belts on. Oh, the radar, I see an aircraft, but far away. Is that 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, almost 90 miles away? I can show you here on Swift, far away. We have 85 miles to the field. Oh, we still have the Gao view, are active here. Of course, that's not correct. Uh-oh, I think we're coming in too high. Let's go direct to Gilbaum. Okay, that's way too high. 60 miles, we should be 5,000 feet lower now. I made a mistake, I didn't catch the fact that I still had a few waypoints and that shouldn't have been there. Well then, speed intervention, let's call maximum speed. That will give us a steeper angle. And I can help it with the speed brakes extended. Right of descent, 6,800, not bad, huh? But still no reception of the Gao view on. That's strange. Speed brakes. So we have 50 miles to go, we had 15,000, we're back on our correct descent profile. But I keep a higher rate now. We want to reach, we want to be a little bit below the profile to reduce speed before passing 10,000 feet. Oh, it's quite hazy here as well. So you see, at the moment we are aiming at 2500 feet, way before, that's 10 miles before. But I will reduce the rate very soon to cross 10,000 feet at 250 more or less. So I select vertical speed now, I keep the rate and we reduce the speed command to 240. I missed the slowdown speed reduction point. Let's take right after some 100. So 260 almost, 250. And we go back to VNAV. VNAV path green. Speed 240. There we go. Come on, catch up. Reduce the rate. We are back on our path. Yeah, track. Not yet. We have our RMP, LNAV, VNAV indication here, our virtual glide path. So we should be able to use approach mode, let's see. Approach, so final approach course and glide path armed. And no reception of the go viewer strange. Obviously it's not part of the scenery, it's not there. So we got 20 miles to run, we're doing fine. Hello, we're bringing more furniture to Africa. is IKEA. Oh, by the way, after landing, we will... I have no idea. Probably this is the civil apron here. I don't know. You can have a look on Google Maps. So maps.google.com Gao Airport.
Thousand ago.
Yeah, the northern apron, the small one, that's military. And the apron here in the center of the runway, that's civilian. Okay, so we're gonna backtrack. And one task to go. So we will land, turn around, backtrack, and proceed here. So you see here in the vertical situation display, you can even see the 3 degree descent path symbol. And that's probably 1,000 feet above and 500 feet above the gates, like outer marker and middle marker. And as well, with this information as well, we see how many miles we got into the runway. We have 3 miles for the top of descent, or the final approach fix, so let me select flaps 5. Glide path green, gear down, flaps 10. Flaps 15. And now we're back to manual speed. Flaps 25. Flaps 30. And flaps 40. Speed brake armed, and landing check is over, and recall air brake armed, landing data VREF minimum set, about to be completed, altimeter 108, landing, engine start continuous, speed brake, oh we didn't do this I think, so landing, zack, continuous, and wing light. So, here we are already.
Approaching 07 left.
And by the way, the auto selector is set for missed approach 2500. Autopilot off, auto throttle off. Looks like we're a bit low. But it's saying 1.3 miles to the field. We are 300 feet above.
300.
I have no idea what's going on here. maybe the reference to the runway is wrong. Yeah, not 100 feet, yeah. That's good.
50, 40, 30, 20, oh, la, la. 10.
Floating.
Long landing, 6,000 feet remaining.
Don't ask me what it was. I have no idea. Idle reverse. Manual braking. Reverse deselected. Nee, keine Wiederholung. Nein. Ich habe keine Ahnung, was das war. Vor allem, ich weiß nicht, warum der Flieger so tief war. Offenbar stimmt hier Datenbank und
Before you leave the aircraft, please be sure to check your seat pocket, the overhead bin.
Datenbank von Flughafen, Szenerie und Navigationsdaten stimmen nicht überein. Ein bisschen ein Versatz hier. Und deswegen dachte er, er müsste etwas früher landen, früher landen, ja, als die Szenerie wirklich da war. Und wenn es nur 0,3 Meilen waren. Ich habe noch nie Replay gemacht, ehrlich gesagt. Wir müssen noch eine Runde fliegen. Keine Zeit dafür. Gute Ausrede, ne? No Replay. I have no time for that. So, the VNAV started descent by itself without me intervening with descent now. That's good. Oh yeah, by the way, what's our fuel on board? 6,500. Exactly what we need. Perfect. Oh yeah, by the way, we start the APU. Ja, Costa, da musst gar nicht gucken, da hast du nichts verpasst. Und ich mache auch keinen Replay, nein. Kannst du ja gleich anschauen nochmal den Mist, den ich gebaut habe. Ich tue es den Stream wieder abschalten kurz. I will stop the stream for a minute to have a break between the two streams in the system and I will rename the second stream according to the next leg. We're flying one more leg now. Quickly, it's a 50-minute flight to Algeria, so don't run away, not yet. Ja, es war eine angetäuschte Landung und dann eine Landung, ja. Die Landung war super, ja. Perfekt war die Landung, ja. Achso, Flaps up. What else? So, APU connected. Wing light off. Flaps are still moving. I shut down the left engine. Du kannst die Landung gleich angucken, wenn du selber ein Replay machst. Ich mache gerne Kritik, aber jetzt habe ich endlich keine Zeit. Die Ausrede geht immer. So, Flaps up, light out and shutdown number 2. Beacon off, Fasten Belts off. Alright, so I'm stopping the stream now for about 1 minute. Bis später.